Hello students, now I am going to discuss the next topic of the integration. In our previous classes we have already discussed so many topics, just like we have already discussed some integration based on simple method or direct method. In this method we have to just use the formula given in the integration and we will find out the value of the integration. In the next topic we have already find that how can we find the integration by using substitution method. Which method? Substitution method. Now after that we have already discussed which type of function for inverse trigonometric functions. Humne inverse trigonometric functions bhi dekha tha. So inverse trigonometric identities using inverse trigonometric identities. After that we have discussed about some particular functions. That is, under this heading we have already discussed that how can we find out the integration of some particular function. Right? Now after that we have discussed that how can we find out the integration using partial fraction. Integration using partial fraction. If you all have remembered that in our first class of the integration, I have already told you that we can use three methods to find out the integration. The first one was the direct method. The second one was the partial method, and the third one was integration by parts. The first method was which type of method? First method was substitution. The second was partial fraction by using partial fraction, and the third was by part. That now the next step in this topic is that how can we find out the integration using by part. Clear? We have already discussed these two methods in our previous classes. Now in this class we will discuss that how can we find out the integration using by part. Clear? So let us start. Now integration by parts. In this section we will use the formula. Now first of all the question arises, in which type of function we use by part method. As for example, that if a function is of the type that the function and its derivative both of them will be given, then we will use substitution method. Clear? Now we have already discussed that if there are some standard type of function which we can convert into trigonometric identities, then we will use this type of method. Then we have already used inverse trigonometric identities function. Clear? Now under this section the question arises that in which case we will use integration by parts. Now the answer is this: whenever you have given to integrate a function and the function is in the form of a product. Clear? Whenever the function is in the form of a product, it means you have to given a function which can be represented in the form of a product, then we will use integration by parts. For example, if I will tell you that find out the integration of x square e to the power x dx, you can simply integrate e to the power x by using simple method. That you all will know very well that the integration of e to the power x is e to the power x, and the integration of x square is what? Integration of x square is x cube by 3. But if I will say that kindly integrate this type of function which is x square e to the power x, then you don't know that how can you integrate it. Clear? So such type of function we will use integration by parts. Clear? So whenever you will get a function which is represented or represent in the form of a product, then to solve them or to find out their integration, we will use integration by parts. For this purpose, we will use this formula. Suppose I have already told you that under this heading the function will be represented as a product. Now let us consider there are two functions. The first one is fx and the second one is gx, and we have to find out the integration of fx into gx dx. Please try to remember, in the differentiation section we have already seen that how can we differentiate whenever a function is represented in the product form. Then you will say that we will apply chain rule. Whenever you have to find out the differentiation and the function is represented in the product form, then we have to apply the chain rule. Similarly, whenever the function is given in the product form under integration, then we have to integrate it by using by part method. Which method? Integration by part method. Clear? Then how can we solve it? Suppose you have given two functions fx and gx, and under integration sign we have to take in its product. Then how can we find out integration? First of all, first function into integral of second function. Clear? Minus under integral sign. Please pay more attention within this section. Under integration sign, derivative of first function into integral of second function, and then we have to take the integration of whole. Clear? Let us recall it once. Again, first function into integral of second function minus under integral sign. Which function we have to integrate under this integration sign? At first, we have to find out the derivative of the first function and the integral of the second function. Then we have to multiply it, and after that, we have to take the integration of that function. Clear? So, how can we prove this formula? That means, how can we say, or how can you say that this formula comes? Clear? Now, let us see that how can we prove this formula. Suppose u and v are two differentiable functions. Suppose u and v are two differentiable functions, and we have taken that u and v both are function of x. Clear? Now, if I will say, whenever I will say that u and v are differentiable functions, then it means that. What means? It means that the derivative of u and v, both of them will exist. Differentiable means their derivative will exist. Clear? So, d by dx of uv. Now see here, u and v are two functions which is written in the form of product. Then which rule we will apply here? We will apply here chain rule. Which rule? Chain rule. For the derivative, we will apply here chain rule. Then what is the chain rule? First function into derivative of second function. Now which is the first function? U is the first function and v is the second function. Clear? So first function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. You all know this process very well. Clear? Now, after differentiating this function, we will get this. Now integrating both sides, we get integrating the first equation, this equation with respect to x. What we will get? Now integrate it. Now since this is a differentiation, d by dx. Now if we will integrate it with respect to x, then we will get the same function. Then we will get the same function because integration and differentiation both are reverse of each other. Clear? So it is also d by dx represent the derivative of uv. Clear? Now if we will integrate it, then which function comes? Original function. It will give you the original function. So it will give you uv. Now see here, u into dv by dx, we have to integrate this function. So what will be the integration? Integral of u into dv by dx, and we have to integrate it with respect to x. For that we have written here, I have written here dx. Clear? Similarly, for the second part, it is given that v into du by dx, and we have to integrate this part. So we will take the integration sign and we have to integrate it with respect to x. Therefore it will give you integral of v into du by dx into d. Now let us assume that this is the equation number 1. Clear? Now suppose u is equal to fx. Let us suppose, this is our assumption, let us suppose u is equal to fx and dv by dx is equal to gx. Now differentiating u with respect to x, what we will get? Du by dx. If we will differentiate u, then we also have to differentiate fx. Now the derivative of fx with respect to x will give you f dash x. Clear? Similarly, since this is dv by dx is equal to gx, when we will integrate this, which function? Dv by dx, then what we will get? We will get v. Because dv by dx represent the derivative of v with respect to x. And when we will integrate it, then it gives the initial function. So we will get v, and this is equal to integral of gx dx. Clear? Now put all these values in equation number 1, then what we will get? We will get, see here, this is u and v. So u is equal to fx. So I have written here fx, and v v is equal to integral of gx dx. So I have written here integral of gx dx. This is equal to under integral sine u into dv by dx. So under integral sine u, what is the value of u we have assumed here? We have assumed here fx and dv by dx. What is the value of dv by dx? This is gx into dx. I have written dx here. Yes? Now, the second part, under integral sine v. What is the value of v? Integral of gx dx. So I have written this term within the bracket. Clear? And du by dx. What is the value of du by dx? It will give you f dash x. So I have written here f dash x and dx is written as c. Clear? Now let us rearrange all these terms. I have taken this term towards the left hand side. So it will give you integral of fx gx dx. Clear? This is equal to, and I have taken this term towards the right hand side, then this will give you fx into integral of gx dx. Now, minus integral of f dash x. I have written this term at the first place, and integral of gx dx as it is, and after that we have to integrate all these functions. See? So, this will give you the method which we will use to find the integration of a function which is represented as a product, or this gives you the formula for the integration by parts. Clear? Means how can we integrate the function which is represented as the product? This is first function into integration of second function minus under integral sign. At first we will find the derivative of the first function, then the integral of the second function, and after that take their product. At last we have to find the integration of the whole function. Clear? This is the formula which we have to use. So now the next question arises that which type of function will be the first function and which type of the function will be the second function. Is there any restriction in taking the first or second function? Then the answer is yes. Then what is their solution? The solution is that we have to take the first and second function according to this chart. Now this is I late, where I stands for inverse trigonometric function, L for logarithmic function, A for algebraic function, T for trigonometric function, and E for exponential function. Clear? Now, whenever you have to given the function in the form of a product, then it is obvious that the function will represent the different branch. Suppose the function is given as x square e to the power x. You have to integrate this function. Clear? Now, tell me which type of function is x square, then you will say that this is algebraic function. Which type of function? This is algebraic function. And which type of function is e to the power x? Then you will say that this is exponential function. Which type of function? Exponential function. Now, see out the place of these two type of functions. Algebraic function is here and the exponential is at the last place. Then we will take the second function which is at the last place and the first function which is the above, which is at the higher place. Clear? Table ke according, hum decreasing order mein jayenge. Jo niche aayega usse hum kya manenge? Second function. And jo bhi aapka upar aayega usse aap kya manoge? First function. Clear? So according to this chart, this will be the first function and this will be the second function. Now one can ask me that what's the reason for taking the first and second according to this rule? The answer is that if I will say, I will give you that solve the question sine inverse x upon 1 plus x square, or I will give you x upon 1 plus x square dx. And I will say you that solve these two questions. Then which one will be easier to you? Then you will say that this one will be easier for you because you can use here, you can see here the algebraic function and you will directly put the substitution rule. Clear? And this is the inverse trigonometric function. In inverse trigonometric function case, sometimes the functions become so much complicated. But for the exponential and algebraic function, you can use direct formula. Clear? So therefore, whenever we have to take the first and second position for the function, we have to suggest the first and second position. We have to follow this chart. Whatever the function comes at the last place, it will be shown the second function. And the function which is at the higher place or at the top level, it will give you the first position of the function. Clear? See here. Why? Because under integration by parts, the second function goes the under the integral sign, and the first function has to go under the differentiation sign. We can differentiate every function very easily, but to find out the integration, sometimes it becomes very complicated for us. Clear? So we have to follow this rule. I late. Clear? So let us consider some example based on this. Now the first example is x sin x dx. Now if I will ask you that which function is the first function and which function is the second function, then first of all categorize it. Since x is an algebraic function, x which type of function is it? It is an algebraic function. And which type of function is sin x? It is a trigonometric function. And I have already told you that you have to arrange them according to I late. I late. Now algebraic function is x. Algebraic function is x, so it will become first. And trigonometric function is sin x, so it will become second function. Is it clear to you all? Clear? So let us start that how can we solve this. Now see, this is first function and this is second function. Now what is the formula for integration by parts? We have to solve it like first function, we have to return the first function same x into under integral sign second function sin x dx minus within integral sign the derivative of the first function, which is d by dx of x, into under integral sign sin x dx. Clear? Now it will give you x, and what is the integration of sin x? You know very well, this is minus cos x, so we will take the minus sign outside. Minus, what will be the derivative of x with respect to x? It will give you 1. And the integral of sin x is minus cos x. This is dx. Clear? So this will give you minus x cos x plus, when we will take the minus sign outside, then it will become plus under integral sign cos x dx. So it will give you minus x cos x minus or plus. It will be plus because the integration of cos x is sin x, so it will give you sin x plus t. So this is the integration for the given function. Without using bipart method, it is not possible for us to integrate this function. But bipart method makes this question easier. Clear? Now let us consider one more example. The second example is tan inverse x dx. Now if I will tell you that arrange them as a first and second function, then you will say to me that there is only one function which is tan inverse x, there is no any other function. Then what can we do this in such type of case? Then we will take 1. See, we can write it as 1 into tan inverse x dx. Is it clear? Now 1 is which type of function? Algebraic function. And tan inverse x is which type of function? Tell me. It will be the inverse trigonometric function. Clear? So इसमें आपका क्या आएगा? Tan inverse x. तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग आपको इसे क्या मानना पड़ेगा? Then we have to take it as a first function and 1 is an algebraic function, so it will become as the second function. Is it clear to you all? Clear? So let us integrate it. So it will give you, the first function will be written as it is, so 1 tan inverse x into integration of second function, which is second, this is second and this is first. Clear? So 1 dx minus under integral sign derivative of first function, so it will give you d by dx of what? D by dx of tan inverse x into under integral sign 1 dx, and after that we have to take the integration of these two functions. Clear? So it will give you tan inverse x is written as it is. Now what will be the value of integral of 1? So it will give you x. Clear? Minus under integral sign d by dx of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. the derivative of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. And the integration of 1 dx will give you f, and we have to integrate this. Okay? Now, this is x tan inverse x minus c. I have already told you that at first, look out the function and categorize it that by which method we can solve it. See? As usual, you can see that this is a function which is represented in the product form. Clear? But as you can see here, this is the first function and this is the second function. Let us see that whether the derivative is present or not. See here, 1 plus x squared. When we will differentiate the 1 plus x squared, then its derivative will be 2x. It means x. Clear? So we will use here substitution method. And you have already learned about this method. So when we will take this as t, when we will take this as t, then what we will get after differentiating it, we will get, see here, let 1 plus x square is equal to t, then differentiating both sides with respect to x, we get 2x dx is equal to dt. So it will give you x dx is equal to dt by 2. Clear? So when you will put here t, see, x dx is dt by 2, so dt, and we will take 1 by 2 as common. See? And this will become t. And what is the integration of 1 by t? Then you will say that 1 by t is log of t. 1 by t is log of t. So we will write here log of, put the value of log of t. So t is what? T is 1 plus x squared. So it will give you 1 plus x squared. Then it will give you 1 plus x square plus c. So this will be the integration for the given function. Clear? Now, one more question is e to the power 2x sin x dx. See here. E to the power 2x, this is an exponential function. E to the power 2x and sin x is trigonometric function. Clear? Now, according to you, we will take sin x as the first function and e to the power 2x as the second function. Clear? Is it clear to you all? Now, whether it is possible to integrate the given function or not. So, let us just check it. Now, let I is equal to e to the power 2x sin x dx. But what's the reason to take this as I? At first, we will see the solution. After that, I will tell you the explanation. That's why I have taken this as a I. Clear? So, let us integrate it. So, it will give you, this is the second function and this one is the first function. So, I is equal to sin x first function as it is into integral of second function minus under integral sign d by dx of sin x into under integral sign e to the power 2x dx, when then we have to integrate this whole. Clear? So I is equal to sin x, when we will integrate e to the power 2x, then it will give you e to the power 2x upon 2 minus d by dx of sin x is cos x, d by dx of sin x is cos x, and e to the power 2x is e to the power 2x upon 2 d. Is it? Now, I is equal to e to the power 2x upon 2 into sin x minus, take the denominator 2 outside. Now, again, this is the function in the product form. And we can't integrate cos x into e to the power 2x by direct method or substitution method or standard function, by using a standard function. So again, we have to use here which method? By part. So again, this is trigonometric function. this is exponential function. So this is first and this is second. Now the first function is written as it is into integral of second function minus under integral sign d by dx of cos x into e to the power 2x dx, then we have to integrate it whole. Okay, then put the bracket here. See, I is equal to e to the power 2x upon 2 sine x minus 1 by 2 ps cos x integral of e to the power 2x, you know it very well. Cos x into e to the power 2x upon 2. Now, see here. See. D by dx of cos x is minus sin x, and this will give you e to the power 2x upon 2. Now the minus sign is present here. Clear? When we will take this minus sign as common or outside, then it will become the positive. So let us make it positive. It will be positive. Clear? Now see here. E to the power 2x sine x dx on the integral sign I have taken, this is equal to I. So we will put its value. So it will give you I is equal to e to the power 2x upon 2 sine x minus 1 by 2 e to the power 2x upon 2 cos x 1 by 2, and this whole is equal to I. Okay? Plus C, some constant. So I is equal to e to the power 2x upon 2 sine x minus e to the power 2x upon 4 cos x minus 1 by 4 I. Now take one minus 1 by 4 I towards the left hand side. So it will give you I plus 1 by 4 I. This is equal to e to the power 2x. Take e to the power 2x as common. So this is sine x upon 2 minus cos x upon 4. Okay? So this is equal to 5 by 4. 5 by 4 I. This is equal to e to the power 2x. Now, sine x upon 2 minus cos x upon 4. Now, taking the cross multiplication, what will you get? You will get I is equal to, see, this will become 5e to the power 2x upon 4 and sine x upon 2 minus cos x upon 4 plus c. So I is equal to 5 e to the power 2x. Taking 4 inside, we will get what? See, something is mistake here. This is not 5 by 4. This will give you 4 by 5. See, this will give you 4 by 5. 4 by 5. See, now. So, now we will take this 4 inside the bracket. When we will take this 4 inside the bracket, then there is no need of 4. It will give you 1 by 5. And when we will take 4 inside the bracket, then it will get multiplied in both these terms. So it will give you 2 sine x minus cos x plus c. This will be the integration. See? Now, still the question remains same. What is the need to take this function I? Why I have taken this function as equal to I? The answer is this, that see out in this question. See out in this question. See, this is taken as the first function. And after some step, when I have taken its derivative, it gets exhausted. See, but in this case, the first function is sine x. And in every step, it does not get exhausted. Whenever you will differentiate it, either it will give you cos x or it will give you sine x. But in case of algebraic functions such as x, x square, x cube, it will get exhausted after some finite step. कुछ स्टेप्स के बाद जो एल्जेब्राइक फंक्शंस होते हैं उनका डेरिवेटिव आपका कांस्टेंट हो जाता है, वन हो जाता है. लेकिन साइन कॉस के केस में क्या होता है, आपके डेरिवेटिव कभी खत्म नहीं होते, वो रेगुलरली अपने आप को क्या करते हैं, रिपीट करते हैं. साइन का कॉस, कॉस का साइन, साइन का कॉस, कॉस का साइन. तो ऐसे जो हमारा ये प्रोसेस है ना प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म का, ये बना रहेगा. जैसे देखिए यहाँ पे ये आपको फिर से ये फंक्शन मिल गया था, तो अगर हम ऐसा नहीं करेंगे तो ये प्रोसेस आपका बना रहेगा. देयरफॉर टू कंप्लीट दिस इंटीग्रेशन वी हैव टू टेक दिस एज इक्वल टू आर. This is some standard function. In this type of function, you have to take the original function as equal to I. See? You will already get clear that in which case you have to take it I. It will depend on the practice. See? Now, one more type of integral is that, see, this is very important integral, e to the power x and within bracket fx plus f dash x dx. Whenever the function is given in this form, then what will be in its integration? Its integration will give you e to the power x f of x plus c. See, whenever the function is given in the form of e to the power x within bracket function and its derivative, both are given and separated by the sign of plus, then its integration will give you e to the power x f x c plus c. You do not need to solve this function in such long steps. You will directly apply this identity and you will get the answer. Now, if I have to apply this identity, then we should know that how this identity comes. Clear? So let us see. Let this function is equal to I. Let us take this function is equal to I. Now, integral of first function and the second function is within the bracket. So first of all, we will open the bracket. So e to the power x fx dx plus under integral sign e to the power x f dash x dx. This is by the algebra of integrability. Clear? Now, see? Now let us say this is equal to I1. What we have taken here? We have taken here this is equal to I1. So this will convert into I is equal to I1 plus under integral sign e to the power x f dash x dx. Clear? This is equal to I1, so this will be integral sign e to the power x f dash x dx. So I is equal to I1 under integral sign e to the power x f dash x dx. Now let us take this as equation 1. See? Now, since I1, what we have taken, I1 is equal to this. Our assumption is that we have put I1 in the place of this integral. So let us integrate it. Now, again, since this is represented as a product of two functions, so we have to apply here integration by part. And what is integration by part? This is an algebraic function and this is an exponential function. So the first function and this one will become the second function. Now, the first function into under integral sign second function minus under integration d by dx of first function. Then integrate second function and after that we have to integrate the whole function. This is the integration by part. Clear? So I1 is equal to fx is fx. Clear? Now what is the value of integration of e to the power x? E to the power x. There is no need of dx. There is no need of dx to write dx, okay? Because integral of e to the power x is e to the power x minus derivative of fx is f dash x and the integral of e to the power x is e to the power x. This dx comes from this, clear? Now, from first, put this value of I1 in equation 1 देन व्हाट यू विल गेट, आई इज इक्वल टू, आई वन की वैल्यू क्या है आपकी, ए टू द पावर एक्स एफ एक्स सी ए टू द पावर एक्स e to the power x f x minus f dash x e x under the integral sign minus f dash x e x under the integral sign dx plus this term is already present in the first equation under integral sign f dash x g x. So under the integral sign e to the power x f dash x dx plus some constant, because whenever you have to you will take indefinite integration, then you have to put some constant after the integration. Clear? Now you can see that both these two terms are same, so they will get cancel out each other. Clear? So I is equal to e to the power x f x plus c, and what we have taken I is equal to क्या था, हमने I किसे लेट किया था, दिस इज इक्वल टू हमने क्या लेट किया था, I लेट किया था. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे जब हम I की वैल्यू रख देंगे तो क्या मिलेगा हमको, e टू द पावर एक्स एफ एक्स प्लस एफ डैश जी एक्स इज इक्वल टू e टू द पावर एक्स एफ एक्स प्लस सी. सो दिस विल बी यूज एन एज अ फॉर्मूला, दिस विल बी यूज एज अ फॉर्मूला, नॉट यूज एन, यूज एज अ फॉर्मूला. इसे हम एज अ फॉर्मूला के जैसे क्या करेंगे, यूज करेंगे. क्लियर, कैसे यूज करेंगे, फंक्शन का फॉर्म कैसा होगा, एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन होगा, ब्रैकेट में दो फंक्शंस दिए रहेंगे, क्या दिए रहेंगे, दो फंक्शंस दिए रहेंगे, और दोनों फंक्शन का क्या रहेगा, सम रहेगा. पहचानोगे कैसे आप, कि जो फंक्शंस दिए रहेंगे आपको, फंक्शन उसका डेरिवेटिव दोनों दिया रहेगा, फंक्शन उसका डेरिवेटिव दोनों दिया रहेगा, एंड दे विल गेट सेपरेटेड बाय द साइन ऑफ प्लस. मे बी यहाँ माइनस साइन हो, तो माइनस का प्लस लाना जानते हो, माइनस कॉमन ले लोगे इधर तो ये प्लस हो जाएगा. ठीक है, और फिर आपको इसे इंटीग्रेट पूरा करने की जरूरत नहीं है, आप डायरेक्टली क्या करोगे, आइडेंटिटी को यूज करके क्या लिख दोगे, ई टू द पावर एक्स एफ एक्स प्लस सी, ये इसका क्या हो जाएगा, आंसर हो जाएगा. ठीक, सो लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल बेस्ड ऑन दिस थ्योरम. नाउ सी, ई टू द पावर एक्स 1 बाय एक्स माइनस 1 अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर डीएक्स. नाउ द फर्स्ट मेथड इज दैट एट फर्स्ट वी विल सेपरेट दिस इंटीग्रेशन इन टू टर्म्स एंड देन आफ्टर दैट वी विल इंटीग्रेट इट, दिस विल बिकम वेरी लेंथी प्रोसेस. क्लियर, सो वी विल यूज द थ्योरम और द प्रॉपर्टी सी. नाउ लेट अस सी, लेट दिस इज इक्वल टू एफ एक्स, लेट f of x is equal to what, 1 upon x, then what will be f dash x, then f dash x will be minus 1 upon x square, so you will get fx as well as f dash x. So we can write here this as e to the power x, see, 1 by x plus of minus 1 by x square dx. Clear? So it will give you e to the power x, what, fx plus f dash x dx, and what will be its value, its value is e to the power x fx plus c, then what will it give you, it will give you e to the power x, e to the power x, and what is fx, c, what is the value of fx, the value of fx is 1 by x into 1 by x plus c, so it will give you the answer. It will give you the, yes. So today we have discussed that how can we integrate whenever the function is given in the form of a product. For that we have to apply the integration by parts, along with we have taken one more identity, which is of the form what, which is of the form integral of the type this. So students, please revise all these things and try to solve some more questions from your course book. After that, in this class we have already discussed all these things, try to solve some more questions. In next period I will again come with some new topics of the integration. Till then, please continue your study. Thank you so much.